Welcome to something that I probably said I was never going to do. In fact, I'm pretty sure that I did. Not to play a strategy game just because it seems a little bit odd. But then again, 3 years, let's do something a little bit different. It's going to go up once a week in our part, give or take. This is UFO Enemy Unknown, or X-Com UFO Defense, depending on where in the world you live. If you're in the UK, it's UFO Enemy Unknown. United States, X-Com. Because there was already something called XCOM and they didn't want people to become confused or get sued. Probably more of the second part than the first part. A lot of stuff about this game out there, it's all over the place. This is not the new one, this is the old one, evidently. And a lot of people call this a hard game. I disagree. It is a fair game, and by that, your enemies have pretty much the same abilities you do. I mean, they have things in their favor, like game mechanics and whatnot. But you have decision-making. The game has to follow its code. You can do something different. So it's a fair game. Not a hard game. It's a fair game. New game. I will be playing on Veteran. There was a, bug. I don't know if it's fixed in this version. This is the Steam version. I have this game on CD somewhere. But the problem with playing that, I had to get this, is if I play that, I have to shut the sound off for it to work correctly. Yeah, no. Now, we have to put down a base. Probably the two best places to put them is either in North America, somewhere in the United States, since the United States pretty much gives the most money in this game, or Europe. Because there's a lot of countries around it that can give you funding. So pretty much pick one. It doesn't really matter. Let's do the central United States. What about there? Base name. Pancake. No. Something infinitely better than pancakes. Waffles. Yes. Depending on where you put your base, either you want... If you're playing right, if you're playing especially on harder difficulties, North America or Europe, put your first base there. Your second base should go in the other one. That's the general consensus. Now, this is the base I start off with. Time to remodel. Because my base can get attacked. My enemies will show up in either the hangars, which are all over the bloody place, or the access lift. Since I can't pick where the access lift is, I have to design around it. So I need to move the hangers up here. This is going to consume most of my money doing this. Need a living quarters. Need another living quarters. I need large radar. Actually, let's make two of them. I also need general stores. Also need alien containment. Now the thing is, to build facilities, like I'm doing, it has to be adjacent to another square, something that's already been built. So when I destroy this hangar, I won't be able to get rid of the small radar system because this will be dependent on it. But I will eventually get rid of that once I build something there and there. So that has consumed most of my money. Next thing I need to do is equip my craft. Sky Ranger. It comes with people that are going to get renamed. I know that I'm going to use names from games that I've already played on this channel. I know you stole that from so-and-so. Yeah, them and 50,000 other people. Actually, let's bring grenades. But I don't want pistols. They're pretty crap. Heavy cannons are kind of crap. Auto cannons, pretty crap. Rocket launcher, but I only have 4 shots. So let's do that. This is going to be mostly set up. There is going to be some playing because, well, it's going to be an hour apart. This was like 15 minutes. I might not get past this. So let's sell and sack some things. All this, it's not going to be much money. But I need every dollar I can possibly get out of what the game starts me with. With that, I will keep the grenades for now. Smoke grenades, no. Next thing, is I need to purchase and recruit some more rifles and some clips. I started with 8. Maximum right now troops is 14. So I need 6. And a bunch of rifle clips. A lot of rifle clips. Because a strange thing in this game, if you shoot one round out of a clip, I believe rifle clips are 20, so I have 19 and the mission ends, that clip goes away. So you're going to go through a lot of things. Those. But most of the rest of the... I don't really need stun rod right now. I will need it eventually. But let's get 6 more soldiers and as many scientists as I can afford. 9. So that's pretty much it at the moment. Okay, let's rename soldiers. Now, they do have minimums and maximums that they can start with. I actually made a little list. Time units is basically, you know, you consume them to do things, like shoot things. Stamina, they get tired, they do that. Bravery is incredibly important. Her bravery is actually pretty good. The maximum is 60. It can go up. All stats can go up, except for one of the hidden ones. There's actually 3 hidden ones. One you can only see if you hack into the game. But bravery only goes up in 10s, and 50 is quite good. Reactions, that's pretty crap for you. That's actually the minimum. Firing accuracy, you're not that high. It's alright. I mean, it's actually about average. Throwing accuracy really isn't important, and strength is kind of... Strength affects how much you can carry, otherwise people get tired, lose stamina, and that will eventually go into time units, because if someone is really tired, they won't get all their time units back in a turn. Health is, honestly, probably, possibly, the most useless stat of all of these. I know that sounds really, really odd. But if you've played this game before, you possibly understand. Most of the time when you get hit, if you actually get hit, 90% of the time, your character will die. There's a lot of death and disappointment in this, as far as first squads go, before you start getting, you know, protective items. But health isn't really important at this stage of the game. It's do or die. You're Astra Belov. And since first squads tend to be full of death and disappointment, I figure using names that I've used in Might and Magic would be the best place to start, since, well, they are used to that kind of thing. You're pretty average. Give me grabby. Scott Sharp, your accuracy is quite good, as is your bravery. Let's see. You can be Crush. Of course, these people die. You are terrible! Your firing accuracy is almost minimum. You have the minimum amount of bravery. You, sir, are horrible. Pack on. I will make sure to get you killed as soon as possible. Firing accuracy, not bad. The two main things you should really worry about, as far as I'm concerned, two things I mainly worry about is firing accuracy and bravery. Bravery is important because if something bad happens, and it will, and if you're not abusing saving and loading, will affect if they go nuts. And by nuts, I mean randomly shoot all over the place, potentially killing someone else who's not going nuts, causing morale to dip further down and cause more people to shoot each other in the back. So, yay for that. But you, sir, are pretty average. You can be Bob. You know, your name is Otto, and I was going to use Otto for the name of someone useless, but you're not that useless. You're actually pretty decent. But you can keep the name. And, you know, renaming them... from games that I've played before, from my point of view, at least gets me a little more attached to these people, so it's more of a disappointment when they die. Some people like to, when playing this game, is post their stats up in their names instead, the important ones. But you, sir, are also pretty crap. You can be Cedric. Gunter Zander. Firing accuracy is good. Bravery is very good. Reaction's pretty decent as well. Firing accuracy average is like 55. So he's a little bit shy of that. I don't want to use the really good names from the main heroes and whatnot from, you know, other stuff that I've played. Mostly because I don't want them to die immediately. I was playing with the idea of using subscribers' names as characters, but, you know, I'd feel bad naming some useless person after, you know, someone who actually comments a lot and has, you know, interesting things to share with me. So that would feel pretty bad then, and I would be getting, you know, my subscribers killed. Let's not do that. That's kind of silly. You're mediocre. And, well, as far as death and disappointment, characters from Little Samson seem to be a great idea. Tatiana Torben. Bravery is good, firing accuracy is pretty good. You can be Mops. And that's pretty much everybody. These people will most likely all die. Character stats can improve. You know, if Pac-On, for instance, would go crazy and, you know, lose his cool, but he doesn't, he has the chance to gain bravery. Or, you know, if he hits something, his firing accuracy would go up. Or all kinds of stuff like that. If they carry a lot, their strength can go up, etc., etc., etc. You can figure it out. Health. Again, out of all the stats, probably the least useful. It's important, yes, more is always better, and but it's probably the least useful next to maybe throwing accuracy, but I am going to use grenades. Strength, nah. You have 32 strength. Cedric was an owl. I don't think his strength is that high. But that pretty much consists of everything that I can do at the moment, and there is a little bug that I encountered my first time trying to record this. In combat, in a scenario of war, there is an instant win bug. That even though there's stuff still around, you can instantly win and the game hangs up and crashes. Which is what happened in the first recording, and hopefully I have figured out a way to do that, to get around that. A very small UFO, that means there's only one alien on it. So we're going to intercept it, and hopefully shoot it down. Which would be really, really handy. Make a nice cautious attack, hopefully not destroy the bugger right away. If we can hit the damn thing, of course. I suppose recovering something is better than nothing. That's over the water. That really doesn't help me. Alright. Above land. Let's go for a standard attack. Damn it! I need you! Because any UFOs you down, you can recover things from them and research them. And right now, using rifles, we're not going to do too fabulous. I believe I'm over the water. Not above the water, rather. I'm still above land. Ugh. Buddy. Yeah, and this is in the futuristic year of 1999. Hold on. That intercept is going to run out of fuel soon. Yep, I lost it. I'm gonna lose it. Alright. Well, that's disappointing. I was really hoping that beginning your game, especially at this point, downing that first UFO that has almost nothing on it, if you can do that, which doesn't seem to happen to me a whole lot, it can help quite a bit, because you can... Oh, I haven't even started research. Oh, that's bad. Medikit is important. You can save people's lives. Not really... If people get shot at this point, they're most likely dead. Motion scanner can be useful, but laser weapons is the thing I need. Now, every hour in-game, 1 point per scientist will be added to it. Everything has a certain amount of points that needs to reach before you can do anything with it. So I've actually lost quite a bit. Lost a whole day's worth of research. Rifle clip and all that has gotten here. Where are my scientists and troops? Need something to happen. Something that I can actually participate in. Oh, I can't believe I screwed up the whole research thing. That was... I was thinking there's gotta be one more thing I can do. Yeah, that was it. Soldiers! Wow, you are terrible, miss. Toshio? Actually, that sounds like a guy, doesn't it? Toshio, simply because of the O. You! Can be Sir Potato. That's obscure. You're also crap. Yay. You can be Bruno. Also very obscure. Your firing accuracy is pretty good. Your bravery is just above crap. Yataka. Sounds like a woman. You can be Sue. Oscar, you are fantastic. You, sir. I need a good name for you. If someone, I don't mind if they die. Good name. How about generic? Since he's probably going to die anyway. Gaston Bouchard is also fantastic. You can be Ridley. Because Ridley dies a whole lot anyway. Jungo Iwasaki. Fire accuracy is poor at best. Bravery is decent. I'm completely out of useless people. Actually, no. And it fits. I love the dead guy. Welcome to the team. I will make sure to get you killed as soon as possible as well. Just because, yeah. Make sure you get these people on the Sky Ranger. Otherwise, they will not be able to participate in fights. And honestly, I probably don't need this many people. Now, let's fill up on grenades. Let's probably buy some more as well. Give everybody 2 reloads. So I have a full Sky Ranger. Now, if I can shoot down a flipping UFO. Anything? Research completed. Laser pistols can now be researched. Which I need to get to the thing I actually want. The laser rifle. The pistol is kind of crap. It's doesn't cost many time units to use to fire, but it is incredibly inaccurate, and I almost never use it. I'd rather use a normal rifle, even though I think they're pretty much the same. Come on, ooh, it's on the ground. Now, a little trick. If you intercept with an interceptor or something on the ground, it usually does not take off. I want to save again, just in case the game crashes. I'm going to be saving a lot just to try to avoid that. And it's day. Nice. So this is the first mission. Most likely, people will perish. Barbie's the first one out. Let's see if she's the first to die. Well, I'm up against the edge of the map, so that's not bad. Save a snapshot, which is important. Oh! Grabby's dead. Well, that didn't take bloody long. Crush, can you avenge Grabby, your companion? Well, not your companion. Please don't shoot, Crush. You can see it now. Now, crouching, which I don't even think I have enough to use for. Actually, I do. Crouching takes 4. And if I auto, it also increases your accuracy and decreases the chance that you'll be hit since you are a smaller target. Nice hit, can you kill him? You cannot. Well, I can't believe it, but I'm going to rely on Pacon with his 16% on an auto shot. No line of fire. Why did you go that way? I don't have any line of fire in this. I have to be in the other aisle. Mr. Alien, sir, if you're going to shoot one of those two blokes, could you shoot Pacon, please? Okay, Bob, you and I have a very long history. Can you kill the alien? No, that's the bush. That's the alien. Good job, Bob. Killing aliens gets people promotions. It's time to save and also put up the fire speed a little bit. I'm not going to sit here and save and reload constantly. That's just wrong. And, well, auto. It makes it a lot easier to get places with your team. Everybody can become, you know, some superhuman. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to try to do it the way the game was intended. Alright, Otto. You stay there. Next out is Cedric. Wow, I'm just getting the A-team out today, aren't I? Well, like the D-minus group. Anyway, that's good enough for this turn. Hear that? This is why sound is important. Oh, there's a dude. During the alien's turn, you can hear things, like that little noise. That was actually a door in their UFO. Cedric, you are the closest. Can't quite see him while crouching. Probably not. Oh no, you get a snapshot. Can you save your own bacon? Clearly not. Let's save a useless person with another useless person. Yay. You know, all you get is a snapshot, too. Right in the face! How do you like breathing through that extra orifice? And there's the UFO. It's one of those small ones. The very small have one alien in them. The very smalls have one. The smalls have, I think, 4 to 6. Anyway, Pacon, try to do something, and I need to save for snapshots. I'm in a corner, so I don't need to worry about this direction anymore. Crush, can you come this way and see what's in front of the ship? That's also a corner. This map is incredibly tiny. Well, Bob, you have one kill under your belt, but you are still a rookie. So your red shirt is good until the end of the mission. Alright, Mops. Let's get you out here. Get you some action. Nope. He didn't shoot me. And I can see him, so there's definitely at least one or two more aliens. Probably more. Cedric has a shot, and he's already kneeling, so I might as well use it all. Auto shot fires 3 times, the accuracy is pretty crap, but it does give you 3 chances. You hit him, and you hit him again, and maybe make him grow crumpled thud? No? Well, you have a grenade. Actually. Otto, do you have a grenade? You do! Let's prime it, set it to 1, and throw it. Why can't I throw there? Does your throw... I gotta get rid of this grenade. It will explode. It will. Just get rid of that. I was hoping, Otto, that you could have done something with that, but nope. 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 Alright, Mops. don't really want to send you up here, but then again, you are a red shirt. Can't see him, but she can still shoot at him. Isn't that fantastic? Right in the face. Didn't... Aliens completely impervious to getting shot in the face. It's like, oh, that's fine. Actually took care of a pimple that I had. He lived. Still lived? There goes that grenade. That's why I got rid of it. Well, Cedric, you have 2 fatal wounds. I'm really surprised that you didn't die outright. That's kind of strange, but in, you know, 12 turns, he will die anyway. So let's see... Actually, no. No? Mobs, if you could you get a promotion from this alien? Try shooting the alien. Try shooting the alien? No? There you go! And again, the sound is important because now I can hear them die. But if we don't hurry, that dude is going to bleed out and die horribly from his injuries. Come, Bob. We have exploring to do, and I'm sending you off by your little lonesome. That's probably a bad idea. I'm surprised only one guy has died thus far. Usually by now, my entire crew has been met with an unsavory end. Alright, KO, time to poop bombs everywhere. Slowly make my way to the ship. That's 1, maybe 2 aliens left. Don't know where they are. Otto can't see anybody. I don't think there's anybody in that corner. There's only a couple of squares. But Bob, could you check it out anyway? No. They're all on the ship. Whoever's left is in the ship. So... No. Pick Mops, please. Try to get a couple people over to the ship and storm my way in. Notice, despite this being, you know, an attempt to save the world from aliens, we're pretty much here in standard uniform. Also, I didn't even mention the story. The whole thing is, all the nations of the world have been trying to down UFOs. They cannot. So have banded together to form X-Com. Losing your base is bad. However, if you do extremely badly, you will lose your funding and XCOM will be disbanded. So there's multiple ways to lose. Aliens get points doing various things, we also get points. Final score for the end of the month is whatever they get, well, whatever we get, minus what they get. Well, Otto, you're in. There's 3 of them. And then there's that funny yellow orange substance in the middle. Well, Otto, you've done your job and most likely you're going to bleed to death. Mops, come in and shoot this guy. Hopefully you have enough TUs to get the heck out of Dodge. Hopefully. I can't get her far enough to hide behind the craft. So here's to hoping. Actually, Otto, since you're going to die anyway and you're kind of crap, let's just put you in front of the thing. Now, the thing about aliens. They're UFOs. The doors automatically close. So I'm hoping if he does come out, Otto will die instead. The heck did he just do? Oh, jeez, there's more of them. Well, Otto, I don't think you can miss. You're dead now. That's alright, your sacrifice was not in vain. Ops. If you don't shoot this guy, you're going to die. Good. I wish you could get you out of there because I don't know what that is on the ground. Oh, there goes Mops. Didn't even see that alien. Oh yeah, Cedric, you're bleeding to death. I forgot about you. Come on, KO. You know, this game did start off pretty well, and I was going to be amazed if I made it very far with only that one death. But never mind. Also, probably should keep track of who dies and who does not. Already lost Mops, though. That's sad. I was hoping Mops would at least survive one or two missions. Would have been nice. Did you just see another alien, Bob? Did one of them not die and was merely unconscious? The thing is... aliens don't have fatal wounds, and you do. It's one of the advantages they have over that balances out, you know, your decision-making, which I'm doing wonderful at. They don't bleed out. An alien can be knocked unconscious through fire. It's rare, but it happens. And they'll usually drop their weapon. The thing is, they might be holding a grenade. So I'm going to save. Just in case the game crashes. That's... oh, there goes Bob. Alright, KO. In you go. Point blank, you can't miss him. Can you shoot this guy too? No. He doesn't have a gun, though. You can see, he literally does not have a gun on him, so he's perfectly safe to stand in front of him, unless he has a grenade. Hey, buddy. How about an auto shot in the back? I don't think this mission went very well. 113? Really? Even though I lost 4 operatives. Well, that's something, so Crush and Sue have been promoted to Sergeant, and anybody else who killed anything are now squatties, I believe. So I lost 4 guys. The things that I got in that fight automatically come back to my facility. Do not sell Illyrium 115. Rest of this, though, I'll save just one for research. Notice, you know, things are automatically back to my base almost instantly. Let's sell navigation. Do not sell alien alloys either. I go through a lot of those. So I need to buy 4 more lives to throw away. Also, I'm going to save and restart my recording since it is an hour, but I'm worried that Fraps caused the crash and I don't want to use the recording thing in DOSBox because it's a very, very small video width and height-wise, and I don't want to stretch it out because it's too fuzzy. Anyway, I will be back shortly with the continuation of this part. So I'm back. All that stuff happened. That was a decent first mission. Decent. Decent. It was decent. Squatty Cedric is wounded, and he'll be in recovery for 16 days. See, these little bars, these are where people improve. Got some strength, oddly. KO got some HP. Okay, time units, which is really good. And a little bit of firing accuracy. Sir Potato did nothing. Bruno didn't really get anything useful, so we've got some time units. It's not bad. I need to use you, Generic. Ridley I need to use as well. because you're fantastic, and Crush got a little bit of just about everything. Pac-On, you killed somebody? Array! So doing stuff makes them better, which makes sense. General Stores has been completed, research has been completed, that's a laser pistol, I'm not going to make any. The main reason I want laser guns is the fact that they don't need to be reloaded. For one, and for two, they are so much better than regular rifles. Mostly because of not having to be reloaded. I don't know about their accuracy, though. Need something else to happen. Okay, peoples. Awesome. Soldiers. Time to rename them. They're all over the place. You are pretty abysmal. You can be KG. Crush is good. Kenji Shoji. Alonzo. Michelle it's not Michelle, it's Michelin? It sounds like a woman, and you're pretty good. You can be Boom Pow. Although your accuracy really doesn't. Helga, which is an ugly name, well, from where I am, Helga just... It seems like an ugly name. It's the same thing with Miranda, and that can be who you are. No, Meredith. Meredith. I'm sure there are very attractive women with that name, it's just the name itself seems unattractive to me. That's everybody. Oh yeah, I didn't replace the, wounded guy, did I? Don't need to worry about that. However, no, Pac-On needs to come. I need to kill him. I don't think I have any space to, Oh no, if I have living quarter space, I don't need troops. What I need is more scientists. Scientists will win this game for you. That is what you need more than anything. And most of your money will actually come from selling things, or making things that you learn from the aliens. Most of your money, the funding, as the game goes on, doesn't become as important since how much you're spending. Average. That's good. Hopefully soon I can make some laser rifles for everyone. Which would be very nice. Small, very low. Don't want to shoot it down over the water, otherwise you cannot get anything from the ship. That's nice, but let's wait a while. So I'm overland and can actually recover the things that are in it. I have some Illyrium, which is good. I wouldn't mind any extra. UFO crash lands, most likely. The thing is, depending on the crash, the Illyrium will explode and you won't get it. The cautious attack is most likely the only way you're going to get Illyrium, unless you get lucky like I did and find one right on the ground. It's nighttime though, I really don't want to attack that UFO during the night. You cannot see as far. The aliens, however, can. The sight does not change during the night. Crash site number 3. And again, I need to save, just in case the game crashes. So I don't have to throw away, 40 minutes of stuff I've already done. Alright, KG. You are scouting, sir. Up against that edge, that's a decent start. Don't see any ship or alien. crush, I would really like you not to die. Although I would like to do stuff so you can at least improve your stats. Don't know how long you'll actually live, though. Yeah, don't become attached to people. You can, in theory, get everyone up to superhuman levels. If, you know, you do stuff to improve it, you do actions that improve that stat, and blah blah blah. Do a whole bunch of saving and loading, because as you've seen so far, it's quite easy for people to, you know, get shot in the face and perish. Oh! Don't shoot Crush! Where'd that shot come from? Came from this direction. Crush. Look for him. Just creep forward ever so slightly. Yeah, oh, no, no, now I see him. He's there. KG, can you take a shot at him? Or is the hedge in the way? The hedge is in the way. Let's get you over here. I didn't save enough for a snapshot. I need some backup for Crush. At least someone who's going to get shot instead. Because if your higher ranking officers get shot, morale takes a huge nosedive. Compared to a, you know, regular soldier getting shot, there is a big difference. Thankfully, sectoids are incredibly inaccurate. And they're opening doors. Thing to note, their doors close automatically. They don't close other people's doors. Alright, Crush. 21%. 3 shots. No line of fire. Of flipping course not. You, however, shoot up the hedge. And then shoot him. Or, you know, do some landscaping. That's fine, too. At least give him another... Oh, there's another one. Where's the other one? He's up on the building? Sir? Yeah, like Pac-Con's gonna be able to hit him. Please! Crouching, you only have 16% on an auto shot. Yeah, I can't hit him. Can you do it while standing? Because that alien can pretty much see everything. So getting rid of him is pretty big priority. Of course, Pac-On can't do anything without Master Chang around. Come on. Can you hit the alien? That would be nice. Crush, do you have enough time units to take a pot shot at that guy? I kinda would like to kill him. No, up a little bit. No, still up a little bit. That is an unconscious alien. This would be good if I had alien containment already constructed. It would be. However, I don't. Alright, Alonzo, your mission, since you have to accept it, is to find the alien craft. Which is most likely down here somewhere. Oh, there's a wall there. Anyway, that's enough for turn 3. Bye, KG. Hey, at least you didn't take a swim in lava this time. Alright, I saw a guy down here. But I also have this other guy that's up here to deal with. Boom Pow, stick to the bushes. You should have saved a snapshot. Pack on! Distract! You can see him? Oh no, he got back up. Well, he doesn't have a gun. Don't worry about him. He might have a grenade, though. That is always the worry. Does the alien scum have a grenade? Alright, those doors are closed, so they might not be in there. Alonzo, there is an alien this way that you can see. Wait. I'm having you shoot through a window and a doorway to hit an alien? Is that alien holding a gun? I don't think he is. Nope. That's not gonna happen. Actually, Crush, do you have enough time units to actually make it over here? Yeah, you do. Unfortunately, that's going to get you killed. No. Go this way and crouch and hope and pray that you don't get shot in the back. I'm sorry, Crush. My inept leading has killed you. I apologize. KO, can you make sure they're off the ramp? Thing that these guys like to do, if they're on the ramp, say right there, and you pick somewhere this way, they'll walk back in the Sky Ranger. It's incredibly frustrating. Please don't kill Crush, please don't kill Crush, please don't kill Crush. Nah. Damn. I'm sorry, Crush, I apologize. What are you doing? Yeah! Was that Pac-On? Did Pac-On just reaction shot someone got some dude in the face? Well, holy crap, Pac-On! You're not as inept as your counterpart in the game you're from. That's amazing. Now, KO, can you see the alien scum for me, please? No, you can't. Or you can get shot, that's fine. Not winning any prizes for this one. Miranda. This is why bravery is important. Oh boy, is bravery important. And Boom Pow didn't die. You miss, have to kill this. Or you can get shot again. You know what? Just... Pack on! Can't believe I'm relying on you. Walk here and shoot the alien. Or, you know, shoot your friend in the back. That's fine, too. Alonzo. You know, if you had killed that alien, I wouldn't have lost Crush. Please don't kill Pac-On. He's actually good. That's fine. She was going to die anyway. Is Pac-On going to become the leader? Really? Pac-On? For crying out loud, Pac-On is going to become the leader, isn't he? No. Ignore that alien! For like the 9th time, just ignore him. Kill that. You hit him? Can you hit him again? That is a dead alien. Killing aliens does increase your morale, this purple bar at the bottom. Still have... Oh, there's the... it blew up. Damn. Alonzo, make your way to the... Oh, there's still the alien down here, isn't there? Let's get into cover. You also need support, my good friend. Well, Miranda and Alonzo. Oh, there's a dude. K kill it. This is a big ship. There's going to be a lot of rewards, even if the Illyrium has sadly explodified. Nice shot. Only took you 6 attempts. Only 1 or 2 aliens left. Yeah, the hidden turn thing lasts only as long as there are aliens. It's a set amount per alien, I think. I think it's longer if that character can actually see them. Pac-On, can you do me a favor and kill the alien that's up on the roof? Since it's convenient at this point. Well, you're most likely going to have to reload. Hit the alien. Hit the alien. He's got like 2 hit points left. Come on, buddy. No. Don't wanna. That's in the building. There you go. So that alien's dead. So all I have to wait for is to get to the ship. There's probably only 1 alien left in it. Yeah, that's about 1. It's either 1 or 2. It's not very many. I know, I'm saving a lot, I'm not reloading. Just because it's a little more stressful if good guys die. So Miranda and Alonzo, after eloping, going to go vacation in the aircraft that's been crashed. The UFO. Yeah, that's 1 enemy. Pac-On, you, sir, are pretty much done for the rest of this video. You have more than done enough. Is there a slobbering beast around the corner? No. The thing is, also, you see the smoke animation inside the ship? Characters can lose energy / stamina in the ship from smoke inhalation. They can actually die from it, I believe. Yeah, let's not do that. And next turn, we'll go in the ship. Still alive. Pac-On. And Alonzo. Oh, no, there's 2 left. Alonzo. Auto-shot this guy, preferably kill him, and then get the heck out. Good job! I'm surprised he actually did that! Miranda, you'll wait till next turn. And the guy just walking around the ship. Why does it keep going to Pac-On? Dropped his gun. Question is that his gun, or is that his friend's gun?
Please don't shoot me in the face, X-Com! I'm sorry!
That I've been abducting your things and doing horrible things to your livestock. Miranda, this time, could you actually reaction shot the guy? That'd be great. I'd like to get you a promotion, but it doesn't look like it's going to actually, he doesn't have a gun. Screw it. Let's get Miranda a promotion. Okay, Pac-On, I know, you're amazing. But I have an alien to murder. 1 shot, 1 kill. That's the way I like it. I lost 4 operatives again, and there's most likely going to be people that are wounded. 7 aliens killed, 22 artifacts, some navigation, no Illyrium, sadly, and some alien alloys. Alonzo Mage Sergeant. Good for him. Oh no, nobody else is wounded. Well, the dead guy hasn't done anything because he's not in the front of the ship. Not bad, Miranda. You actually got a decent boost. So that's that. Couple missions have gone really well. Heavy plasma is really nice. Don't sell... Well, you probably later you want to sell the guns, but don't ever, ever sell the ammunition, because the heavy plasma is actually the best weapon in the game. Yeah. Ooh, mine probe. That's a lot of money. Some sectoid corpses. Somebody wants them. Nice, cool 1.2 million. Yeah, one more day for my living quarters to come out, and I can destroy that. And I'll have enough space to hire some more scientists, which I desperately need. Production of living quarters has been complete. Nice. Dismantle that. And I have, what, 19 scientists? 26, so I need 24 more. Probably cannot afford 24, but I'm going to try. Not enough money. 18. And I'm completely broke again. But that's fine. Scientists, again, will win this game for you. If you do not purchase scientists, you're in for a long and very difficult game. Ah. Fresh meat. Make sure they're on the craft. Oh, Cedric is still hurt. He's going to be hurt for the remainder of the month. Time to rename some people. Sumi! Your accuracy is almost max. You can be Kara. Hans, your firing accuracy is also incredibly good. Have I had a Bowie yet? You can be Bowie. Austin McNeil. You're kind of crap. You can be a zombie. Gerard, oh, your bravery is atrocious, but your accuracy is good. Sam. That's everybody. So far, this month is going pretty decent. And 18 scientists. That's what I want to say. This should complete this relatively quickly. I need 6 more scientists. It goes up to good. And hopefully, very shortly, I can start replacing these horrible rifles with laser rifles. Nice. Now I can research the heavy laser. The heavy laser itself is crap. Oh, I've got a choice. Alien alloys, which leads to something really good, or the heavy laser, which also eventually leads to something good. I need alien alloys, though, extremely badly. I need that to be researched. Allocate manufacture. This gets rather expensive, and I don't have enough money to produce any of them. Alright, no. Time? Stop, please. I need to sell something. Mine probe. At least to have the money to actually make some laser rifles. Everybody's going to be working on them, and I need a lot of these. Well, I need 14 to start, to fill up my ship. They do not need to be reloaded, however, I don't think they're as accurate. And I need some engineers as well. I don't think I have the living space for them, though. For days, I will have, well, 14, I'll have the living space, but I don't have it yet. Can I get any more engineers? I can. Not enough money, I only get 5. Oh, it's better than nothing. By the way, At the end of this month, there is going to be a new kind of mission. Well, we've only been on one type of mission, but there's going to be a new one. I want to make sure I am as prepared as possible. I don't have any laser rifles yet. This is a terror mission. This is probably one of the hardest things you're going to do. Well, they happen every month. You can't ignore them. At worst, if you can't do it, you don't have enough troops, you're in a bad way. The best thing you can do, instead of losing all the troops, is to land and take off. You don't lose as many points doing that as you would completely ignoring it. Can I equip any laser rifles to the craft? I have one. Just one. Gonna have to make sure someone good gets that. But anyway, that is enough for this part, considering the terror mission is going to take a while, and I only have one laser rifle. I was really hoping to have alien alloys done before this, and to have the thing afterwards. That's why I was really hoping to down that very first UFO. But yeah, can't do anything about it now. Time to go do a terror mission in the next part. Until then.